Hello everyone, my name is Dennis and I'm going to present you the dynamic simulation model of the Stupa artificial glacier project by Sonam Wangchu. Please follow the link in the description for an introductory video about the project. This is part one of a series of models demonstrating how temperature will affect the growth and shrink of the artificial glacier, which will be essentially a conic ice mountain. You can follow the link in the description to open a working version of this model on randommodel.com. At this abstraction level, artificial glacier growth is controlled by two parameters, the glacial feed pipe diameter and the glacial flow speed, which is essentially proportional to the altitude difference between the feed pipe head at the real glacier and the location of the artificial glacier. The glacial feed is coming down from the mountain with a certain debit and gives us the available water. So let's start the model and see how does it work. We have the glacial feed, as we said, coming down from the mountain, and then it gives us the available water to form the artificial glacier. A fraction of it is going to freeze, while the rest will flow away. Of course, the freezing fraction will mainly depend on the ambient temperature. The freezing will slowly yield us the artificial glacier, an approximately conic mountain of ice. The growth of the artificial glacier is dynamic. And as we can see, it heavily depends on the day-night cycle, with most of the growth occurring during nights when it's colder outside. You see the temperature here, on average, is below minus 10 down to even minus 30 or less. And it's always below freezing level in the months of January and February. And since we have no melting in these months, this will result in a high net growth of the artificial glacier. You can monitor the melting, freezing, and net growth here. Now, starting with March, the daytime temperatures will often go above zero, even towards the end of February. So, we will start seeing a melting process. Initially, the melting only appears during the day. You see, when the net growth is negative, that means glacier's shrinkage. It's essentially melting. But as we will enter into April, melting gets more pronounced and the artificial glacier starts shrinking. Since melting depends on the surface area of the ice cone, melting will be very pronounced in the month of May, when the artificial glacier is still quite big, but the air is already very warm outside, as we can see. With the current parameter setup, the artificial glacier lasts through the early days of June. It is important to mention that this is only an experimental parameter set, and in upcoming videos we are going to refine these to include more sophisticated modelings of the freezing and melting process, as well as direct solar radiation. Later on we will also look into the outflow part to utilize the artificial glacial melt for irrigation. By July, our glacier has melted completely and the site is ready to set up for next year. Thank you for watching. Please watch the project presentation video, follow us on Facebook, and donate to our crowdfunding campaign on Indiegogo.